हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय किचन। टुडे आई हैव कम अप विद एवरीवन्स फेवरेट, यस दैट इज आइसक्रीम। इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू हाउ यू कैन मेक 2.5 liters ऑफ आइसक्रीम विद जस्ट 0.5 liter ऑफ मिल्क। सो स्टे ट्यून्ड फॉर द एंटायर वीडियो बिकॉज आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर विद यू सम टिप्स एंड ट्रिक्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ विच यू कैन गेट सॉफ्ट स्मूथ एग्जैक्टली लाइक मार्केट बॉट आइसक्रीम। Let's begin with the recipe. Into a vessel, I'm taking 0.5 liter of full fat milk. Meanwhile, keep a whisk like this ready with you. Next, I'm adding around 8 tablespoons of sugar. If you want more sweet, you can add more sugar. If you want less sweet, you can also add less sugar. Next, I'm adding 1.5 tablespoons of corn flour. Do not use those loose corn flours which we get in the grocery stores. I have tried using it. It doesn't give a good texture to the ice cream. Always use a good brand corn flour. It's not too expensive, so you can use it. I'm adding 1.5 tablespoons of corn flour. Next, we need glycerol monostearate. It is used for the thickening of the ice cream and also as an emulsifier. We will need 1.5 tablespoons of GMS powder. It is easily available in the market, in supermarkets or in shops where you get baking items. So here I am adding 1.5 tablespoons of GMS powder. This is the main ingredient which helps us in increasing the quantity of the ice cream. From 0.5 liter of milk, if we want 2.5 liter of ice cream, then this is very important ingredient. Also, don't worry, it is not harmful to your health. Even market bought ice creams use same ingredients, so no need to worry. Also, this product is not too expensive. It's around 50 to 60 rupees, but you can use it for around 4 to 5 batches of ice cream, so it's a good quantity. Okay, the next ingredient that we need is CMC powder, carboxy methyl cellulose powder. This is used as a stabilizer in our ice cream. If we do not want our ice cream to melt faster when we bring it to room temperature, which means when we take out our box of ice cream from the refrigerator and keep it in the room temperature, if we do not want the ice cream to melt faster, then this ingredient is very important, which is CMC powder. We need very little quantity of this ingredient, which is 1/8 teaspoon. We just need 1/8 teaspoon of this ingredient. This also doesn't cost much, and this box goes for a long time because we use just 1/8 teaspoon of this ingredient. Again, this is also not harmful to your health. Even market bought ice creams use this ingredient. Also, both CMC and GMS powder, both are veg, so even vegetarians can use it. Next, we need milk powder. You can use any brand milk powder. I'm adding around 2 tablespoons of milk powder. If you want little more milk powder, then you can go ahead and add around 3 to 4 tablespoons as well. But I'm adding 2 tablespoons. Next, with the help of a whisk, mix it well so that there are no lumps. Make sure that there are no lumps. It is very, very important. Once you mix it all together and make sure that there are no lumps, switch on the gas stove and place the vessel on the gas stove and keep mixing. Do not stop mixing, keep mixing for some time. Next, with the help of a spatula, I am just giving it a gentle stir. Allow the milk to come to a boil and keep giving it a stir until the consistency of the milk becomes like condensed milk. You can also wait until it comes to a boil twice, or once is also fine. It will take around 10 minutes. After around 10 minutes, our milk has come to a boil twice and we have got condensed milk consistency. It's now time to turn off the gas stove and let it completely cool down. Let it completely come to room temperature. Once it comes to room temperature, it will become even more thick. So, let's wait for it to cool down completely. Now that our milk mixture has completely cooled down, I am pouring it into an airtight container. I am closing the lid and freezing it for around 8 hours. This mixture should completely become hard, almost like an ice cream, so do not take it out before that. Okay, it's almost 8 hours. Before I take out the mixture, I want to show you few details. We need a vessel of this sort, which is big enough, inside which we'll be placing ice cubes. On top of the ice cubes, we'll be placing a big vessel. Use the biggest vessel possible because our ice cream quantity is going to increase once we start beating it. So, this is the setup that we need. We are using ice cubes because we do not want our mixture to come to room temperature. We want it to be cool. Another important tool that we need to make the ice cream is this electric blender. You can use any brand electric blender. An electric blender helps us to increase the quantity of the ice cream. With 1/2 liter of milk, we can make 2.5 liter of ice cream. We can also make the ice cream with the help of a mixie, but the quantity will not increase to that level. I have kept a rose essence ready because I am going to make a rose flavor ice cream. Whichever flavor ice cream you want, you can keep the essence ready. Also, I am using few drops of pink gel food color. If you want, you can skip the coloring part. Also, we will need an aluminium foil, or if you have any plastic covers, you can cut it and use it as well. Another ingredient that we need is a whipping cream. Here I am using a non-dairy whipping cream. We will need 1 cup of whipping cream for 1/2 liter of milk. This is sweetened whipping cream. We also get unsweetened whipping cream in the market. So if you are using sweetened whipping cream, then make sure you balance the sweetness when you are adding sugar to the milk in the initial process. Instead of whipping cream, you can also use fresh cream, or you can use even homemade malai. Okay, I have taken out our milk mixture from the freezer. It has become solid. It almost looks like an ice cream. Now let's transfer this mixture into the vessel. With the help of a spatula or a knife, cut the milk mixture into pieces and transfer it into the vessel as shown. Just to make sure that the blades of our blender doesn't get spoiled, we'll crush the milk mixture with the help of a spoon or a knife. Next, as I had mentioned earlier, I'm placing ice cubes on the below plate. Now, with the help of the electric blender, with slow speed, start blending the milk mixture. It will take around 3 to 4 minutes for the milk mixture to completely melt and start getting creamy texture. Slowly increase the speed one at a time and then blend it in medium speed. If needed, in between, with the help of a spatula, just mix the mixture once. And now again, let's blend the ice cream in low speed and gradually increase the speed and reach to high speed. If you have a turbo button in your electric blender, then you can use that as well once you reach the high speed. Can you see the quantity of the ice cream increasing? It has almost become triple its initial quantity. Also, make sure that you start blending the ice cream when it's hard itself. Do not bring the milk mixture to room temperature and then blend it. We want it to be hard as I had shown. After around 7 to 8 minutes, this is the quantity that we have got and this is the texture that we have got. Now into it, I am adding 1 cup of whipping cream. Now again, start blending the ice cream starting from low speed and build up the speed and reach to high speed. After adding whipping cream and blending it, the quantity of the ice cream will again increase. In case the blades of your blender become hot at any point, turn off the blender and let it cool down for some time. Okay, now you can see the quantity. It has increased so much. It's time to add ice cream essence. I am making rose flavored ice cream, hence I am adding 2 teaspoons of rose essence. Next, I am adding 2 drops of pink gel food color. It's completely optional. I had it at home, so I added. If you have liquid food color, then that is also fine. Now let's blend it for another 2 minutes in medium speed so that the color evenly distributes and also the essence evenly distributes. There you go. After around 1.5 to 2 minutes, we have got a creamy rose flavored ice cream. Look at the texture. We need this texture. So until then, keep blending. Now it's time to store our ice cream. Look at the quantity, guys. We just used 1/2 liter of milk and 1 cup of whipping cream, and we have got around 2.5 liter of ice cream. And trust me, just because it's homemade, there is no compromise with the taste and texture. Now tap both the boxes so that if there are any air bubbles, it disappears. Now with the help of a foil paper or a plastic sheet of this sort, just cover the box and then close the lid. This will help us to avoid ice crystals in our ice cream. Actually, it doesn't make any much difference, but for safer side, we'll add the plastic cover. Similarly, I'm closing the other box as well, adding plastic sheet and then closing the lid. Now put it in the freezer for at least 12 hours. Okay, 12 hours are done. Let's see how our ice cream is formed. Wow, I cannot see any ice crystal, and see how smooth and creamy our ice cream has come out. It looks exactly like market bought ice cream, and it definitely tastes also like market bought ice cream. So guys, it's festive season around. How much ice cream is too much ice cream, right? So make this ice cream at home and enjoy this festive season with your family and friends. If you enjoyed this recipe, then do let me know in the comment section. Also, please don't forget to hit the like button, share this recipe with your friends, and also if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, then do subscribe to my channel. See you in the next video.